I've been playing pickleball, which is now my new favorite thing to do. I play pickleball.
Pickleball. Sort of pickleball.
Sort of like a cross between tennis and ping pong. Caught in a pickle, stuck in a pickle.
A lot of people think old people play it.
Pickleball.
It's like racquetball. It's like competitive.
Oh, that guy is good. He's sponsored.
You have an unorthodox swing.
A tennis elbow.
Ping pong.
Tennis.
Ping pong. Okay, so Dan and I are at Jojo's Pizzeria. I don't know if it's Jojo's Pizza. We never bothered to look. We should have brought. Number 84. Pittsburgh Steeler, grade Antonio Brown. Turn.
Here we go.
New England Patriot. Or I'm sorry, turn Tampa Bay Buccaneer. So Dan ordered 10 garlic knots. And we got a pizza this week. One cheese pizza coming up. So have you eaten here before?
No.
So, right over there, is Aldo's.
One, two, three,
C+. We had a mediocre pizza.
I know what that pizza is.
And this was the castle that we visited. We drove by, remember? We're like, go to that place. You're gonna make it work. You're gonna sit outside because it's still two unvaccinated men during COVID. Dan's got his chin diaper on.
Keep my lower lip safe.
Our grub?
No.
No napkins, but here's the pie at Jojo's Pizza. We decided to change spots. What do you think? First impressions?
Here, I'll give you this piece.
And they don't know how to cut a pizza? Really? I'm already disappointed, I'll tell you how much.
Alright, let's do it.
It's not that hot. It looks like half done too, right?
Yeah, it could be cooked before.
And they're pretty busy in there, but there's no excuse. Like, if you're a pizza place, you should be fine-tuned to making good pizzas every single time.
We should totally convince one of these shops to let us do it. That'd be fun. What do you think about us making a pizza?
That'd be awesome. We could do that. I'm sure we could do that. So Dan got some garlic knots. Did you try those yet?
No. Probably get cold as hell. pizza's getting cold real quick.
Yeah. It's just not really good.
I'm trying to figure out what it is exactly that I don't like about the sauce. The cheese, I really don't like.
Yeah, the outside of the crust isn't the worst. It tastes like a store-bought frozen pizza. Like, I could make a pizza like this. I'm sorry, guys. Like, I never want to, like, give a place a bad review. But, and I'm sure Jojo's people are going to end up giving us a hard time about it. And so here's the thing. The Jojo's in Hummelstown is straight fire. Straight fire. Straight fire. Straight fire.
So I wanted these. Normally I do get garlic knots pretty much everywhere we go if they have them. But
you can just tell by picking one up. They're like weightless.
I love that the flavor is definitely there. Everything just seems rushed. Like it's like half cooked.
Mm-hmm.
The flavor reminds me of the garlic knots I used to get in New York.
That's good.
That wasn't that bad.
Jojo's in Hummelstown in the square is really good. They've always had really good New York style pizza. The one out on 22, I want to say it's like past Ollie's on 22, wherever that is.
Look at this.
It doesn't look good. Oh yeah.
What does this sauce taste like?
Like SpaghettiOs?
It reminds me of like ragu.
Chef Boyardee.
Like ragu, yeah. Not Chef Boyardee, but like ragu. Like something like very canned. And,
right. I swear a lot of these places are all using the same BS from distributors in the area. Don't you think I know it's been hard. I feel bad because like businesses are taking a hit. Small businesses like this are taking a hit. But at the same time, the sauce, you can't chintz on quality. You can't be too frugal when it comes to creating a pizza joint. So I have a grade. Do you want let's give it a grade so we can be done with this place? Yeah, so we'll on three. Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3, C. No, we've gotten the grade pretty much. I was actually going to go C minus, but I was like, that's harsh.
Yeah, we were all.
It's edible. Like an F. What else is going on? What else should we talk about? What good? Because all we've been doing is holing up at home, right? So what do you watch on TV when you're home? What do you do when you're home? Besides what?
I make it like halfway through everything I watch.
Okay.
Not even halfway.
Okay.
I don't know what happens. I feel like I'm wide awake and I turn something on and it makes me kind of relax.
But you don't have a show that you're watching?
No, not really.
We just finished WandaVision.
I was watching Trafficked.
Is it like a QAnon thing?
She's a reporter, and she's a very hands-on reporter. She wants to get involved, like, some really dark shit. What do they call it? The iron. She did one on freaking cocaine. And there's times where, like, you can't go with her. And she wants to go, even though if they tell her, they go.
So you didn't watch WandaVision?
Watch that.
My Little Pony.
This box is crap up.
Want to get an owl's? Owls sit outside and get a pizza there.
Owls and pizza.
Straight fire.
I'm an ape man, I'm an ape man, no, I'm an ape man. I'm a King Kong man, I'm a voodoo man, no, I'm an ape man. Cause compared to the sun that sits in the sky, compared to the clouds that say,
it's a shame because they follow me on Instagram, or I follow them on Instagram, or maybe both. And I want to drop the F-bomb, but I'm not going to because there are kids watching. But I'm pretty disappointed.
It was okay to watch it.
Straight fire.